Hello students, today's session is again select operation. I hope all of you got an idea about select operation in the previous session. Also I hope all of you tried the previously given questions. We will continue with select operation today. We will see how select operation works if ambiguous attribute names are given. Ambiguous attribute names means same attribute names are used in various relations. That is, if you consider this example, employee and department table, where name is an attribute which is used in both employee and department. Again, department number is used in both employee and department by using the attribute name D number. Even if name in employee represents name of an employee and name in department represents name of a department, both the attribute name is the same. So we will see one example. Retrieve the name and address of all employees who work for research department. The query can be written as select employee.nameaddress from employee, where the condition is written. So here, along with select statement, we have specified employee.name, that is name of employee is what we have to retrieve. If you have written select name comma address, it's not clear that whether name represents employee name or department name. So we have to specify the table name here, select employee.nameaddress from the tables employee department, where again department name must be research and department number of a department must be same as department number of an employee. The same query can be written like this: select employee.name employee.address. So even if address is used only in employee relation, this is also a correct method of representing a query. Then from the tables where the conditions can be written. We will see another example, that is if the same relation is to be referenced twice. The question is, for each employee, retrieve the employee's first name and last name and first and last name of his immediate supervisor. In the employee relation, we can see name of an employee and his supervisor's name is included in the employee table itself. So to access employee name and supervisor's name, we have to use the same employee table. The query can be represented like this: select e dot first name, e dot last name, s dot first name, s dot last name from employee as e, employee as s, where e dot super ssn equal to s dot ssn. Here we have created two tuple variables e and s. E is a tuple variable of the relation employee. S is again a tuple variable of the relation employee. E represents the details of employees. S represents the details of his supervisor. So here in the select statement, E dot first name, E dot last name represents first name and last name of an employee. Then S dot first name, S dot last name represents first name and last name of a supervisor, where the condition is super SSN of an employee must be same as SSN of his supervisor. E dot super SSN equal to S dot SSN. So E and S are considered as two copies of the relation employee. So if the same relation is to be referenced more than once, you can create as many as tuple variables. We will see another example. If unspecified where clause, that is a where clause is not necessarily to occur in select statement. A missing where clause indicates there is no condition to be selected. Example is select SSN from employee. So there is no condition to be verified. So all the SSN of all employees will be retrieved in the result. Now if two tables are specified, then the cross product, that is a combination of all possible tuples from both the tables, will be retrieved. Example, select SSN department name from employee department. So in the result, SSN of all employees will be retrieved, department name of all departments will be retrieved, then the cross product of SSN and the department name will be shown in the result. Now to retrieve all the tuples from a relation, you can use a star operation. To obtain the results of, obtain the details of all employees in department 5. The query can be written as select star from employee department where department number equal to 5. So here all the attribute values of the tuples which satisfy the condition will be retrieved. Again, another example, retrieve the details of all employees. So we are not specifying what are the attributes to be retrieved. In the question, we are specifying that retrieve all the details of all employees which satisfies the condition. So there we can use star operation, select star from employee department where the condition should be satisfied. Another example is elimination of duplication. SQL usually treats tuples as multi-sets, where relational algebra treat as set of values. That is, in relational algebra we have studied duplicate tuples will never occur. Duplicates will be eliminated automatically. But in a result of SQL statement, duplicate tuple will occur. Duplicates will not automatically eliminated. Example is, we can see in this question, retrieve the salary of every employee. The query will be select salary from employee. Also, it can be represented as select all salary from employee. All is a statement, or it's a keyword which will give you the same result of the just like the previous query. In the result, which is shown in the table here, we can see the same value is repeated more than once. So duplication of tuples occur. Now if you want to eliminate duplication, that is to retrieve all distinct salary of employees, the keyword is distinct, select distinct salary from employee. So if you have written the keyword distinct along with select operation, select statement, the duplicates will be eliminated. Result is shown here. In the result, there is no duplicate tuples. Now set operations in SQL, just similar to relational algebra, here also set operations can be applied in SQL. The necessary condition is the relations must be union compatible. Union compatibility means both the relations should have same number of attributes and they must appear in the same order. The various set operations are union, intersection represented by intersect, set difference represented by except. One example is shown, make a list of all project numbers for the projects that involve an employee whose last name is Smith, either as a worker or as a manager. Here in the query written, we can see the first select statement retrieves project numbers of all the projects where Smith is a manager. Then the second select statement represents, or it retrieves the project numbers of all the projects where Smith is a worker. Then we are applying union operation on both the results of both select operations. So the result will give you project numbers of all the projects where Smith is a worker or Smith as a manager. So that's all about today's session. You can consider this example relations, and you can try these two questions using the operations we have studied. Thank you.